Hello students, in today's video we are going to study adapter classes. Okay, what is adapter class actually? An adapter class provides an empty implementation for all the methods in an event listener interface. To understand this sentence, first we need to see what we have studied in previous class. See, in previous video we have studied about handling mouse events and handling keyboard events, right? In this example, what we have done is we have implemented appropriate listener interfaces, right? For handling mouse events, we have implemented mouse listener interface and mouse motion listener interface. So if you are implementing these interfaces, so these are the mouse listener interface and mouse motion listener interface. If you are implementing these interfaces, means actually you are going to write the body for all these methods as well as these methods. Now the question arises, suppose a user wants to implement the body for only for suppose mouse clicked. Okay, then he or she doesn't want to implement the body for rest of the methods. If you are implementing this interface, you must and should write the body for all the methods, otherwise that class must and should be abstract, right? So what is the solution for this? The solution is adapter classes. See, adapter class provides an empty implementation of all methods in event listener interface. Means Java provides a special kind of classes which will have empty implementation for all these methods. Okay, so what you need to do is you need to create a class and you need to extend that class with one of the appropriate adapter classes, and you need to override one of these method that you want to implement, because one of the adapter class provides empty implementation, empty body for these methods, right? So what are the different adapter classes available? So we have one table here. These are the adapter classes: component adapter for component listener, container adapter for container listener interface, focus adapter for focus listener interface, key adapter for key listener interface, mouse adapter for mouse listener interface, mouse motion adapter for mouse motion listener interface, and last one, window adapter for window listener interface. So in previous examples we have implemented, we have created a class which is going to implement mouse listener interface or mouse motion listener interface. Means you are going to write the body for all the methods declared under these interfaces. But if you create a class and extend one of the adapter classes, extend one of the appropriate adapter classes, you need not to write the body for all the methods. You can write body for only specific methods. So we'll see an example. Before that, see, adapter class are useful when you want to receive and process only some of the events that are handled by particular event listener interface. You can define a new class to act as an event listener by extending one of the adapter classes and implementing only those events which are interested in. Okay, let's see a program on page number 657. I think you have already studied what is apted in previous example. So these are the import statements. So whatever the visual components that we are going to draw, it comes under AWT dot all the classes of the star means all the classes. And to handle the events, we need to import the package java dot AWT dot event. To create an applet, you need to import a package called java dot applet dot star. What is an applet? You can refer my previous video. Now here I have a class called adapter demo and it extends a applet. Means adapter demo is going to be a window. Is going to be a window, huh? See, this adapter class is going to be a window like this. Okay, like this, because adapter is one of the front end. Okay, like JFrame. Okay, I have told you that in adapter applet skeleton we have one method. We have init start, init start service stop destroy. Okay, paint stop destroy. So here one of the method we are overriding. See, you are extending this class, right? Extending this class means for init, for start, for paint, for stop, for destroy, for all these five methods, the implementation is already there in applet class. See, I have already this program written in this NetBeans C applet. In this applet, you will have, see, let me show you. Here you will have init method. See, you will have one method called show status. Huh? Just remember this thing, that we have a method called show status. Show status means to show the information on status bar that you have seen already in browser or any windows. See, in window you have here one item. One item is actually the information about a file which is present in your particular folder, and it is, see, one item selected, 277 MB. Okay, see, now after that, see, we were searching for init, right? So there are lots of methods available. See, you have init here. So init's in empty implementation, there is no body for init. Then we will have start, there is no implementation for start. Then we have stop, then we have destroy, right? Then we have paint method. Actually, it is not accessible here. So paint method. So these five methods will be there in your applet: init, start, paint, stop, destroy. Okay, these five methods. By writing the body of this method, by writing the body of this class of init, means you are overriding this method. You are overriding init method from applet. Okay, in init, what you are doing actually, you are adding mouse listener interface. Okay, sir, again, you are implementing listener interface, means we need to write the body for all the methods. See, what we are doing, we are just adding mouse listener. And to whom? Who will be the listener? Listener will be my mouse adapter. And this is our class called my mouse adapter, which will be our listener. And who will be the source? This window will be the source. On what is the name of this window? The name of this window is adapter demo. Okay, adapter demo. So source will be this window, listener will be my mouse adapter, and my mouse adapter is extending mouse adapter class that you have already seen. What is mouse adapter? See, mouse adapter class. Mouse adapter for mouse listener interface. Mouse listener interface. Now it is extending mouse adapter. Okay, means it can handle now. If it is extending mouse adapter, means, and mouse adapter is for, is an adapter class for mouse listener interface, means it can implement, or it can implement one of the methods, or two or three or four or all among all these methods, override. It can override. Okay, there is no necessity that you have to write the body for all the methods. You can write for 1, 2, 3 or all. Okay, now, so we'll see this entire statement in late in this section. Okay, now see, my mouse adapter extends mouse adapter. My mouse adapter is a user defined class. It is a user defined class. Now what you are doing, you are creating a variable of type called adapter demo class. What is the adapter demo class? This is your adapter demo class, which is a source actually, which is a window which generates an event, and listener is my mouse adapter. You are just creating a variable of this class here, and you are having a constructor. See, my mouse adapter, same name as class name, doesn't have any return type. Just this is just access specifier, and it will take one parameter, which is a variable of type called adapter demo class. Adapter demo class, that is our window. See, it is bit confusing. See, listen properly. What we are doing, we are adding a mouse listener, and the listener will be my mouse adapter. Actually, this is a new keyword, and this is your constructor. And for constructor, you need to have one argument, and argument passed is this keyword. This will be replaced by whom? This will be replaced by the object who is calling it. Now, who is calling this add mouse listener? Adapter demo is calling add mouse listener. So adapter demo's address will be passed in this, and this address actually will be passed here, right? Then what you are doing is, this address that you have received from here, you are storing into the instance variable that you have created under my mouse adapter class, storing into instance variable. And to differentiate between instance variable and local variable, we are using this keyword. Okay, now you have the address of this class, object of address of this class. Okay, because whenever a event occurs, a source generates a object representing a event. So you are generating an object here, you are generating an object here that represents this event, and you are throwing it and you are storing the address. Then use, why you are storing address? To call show status method of applet. Actually applet has a show status method, right? So to call show status method, you need to have the object of applet class actually, but applet is extended by adapter demo. That's why you are calling, just you are creating the object of this class, and through that object you are calling show status, and in the status window you are showing mouse clicked. In this body, and this body is only for mouse clicked event. We have not implemented any mouse pressed, mouse released, right? Then second statement in this window is add mouse motion listener. And who will be the listener? My mouse motion adapter. What is my mouse motion adapter? This is a class, another class, my mouse motion adapter, which is extending mouse motion adapter. And mouse motion adapter is for motion listener, mouse motion listener interface. Mouse motion adapter is for mouse motion listener interface. So it is going to, so it will have two methods, dragged or moved, right? So what you are going to do, we are just writing the body for mouse drag, not moved. Okay, drag. Okay, before that, this class will have a constructor same like previous class, and it will take address of the window, and it will initialize the instance variable with that address, and that instance variable address will be used for showing the message into show status bar. Okay, so let me execute this program for you. See, actually I have already pasted here, copy pasted here. So I will run this program. See, this is our window. There is no mouse entered, mouse exited events here. Mouse clicked, so if I click mouse, you will see here mouse clicked. If I drag mouse, mouse dragged, nothing else. Here user was interested in only in mouse clicked and mouse dragged. That's why you are just getting mouse clicked, mouse dragged. And already we have written only for, we have already written the body for mouse clicked and mouse dragged, right? Okay, proceeding further, inner classes that you have already seen in module 3. What is an inner class? Class within a class. Class within a class. So this problem that you have seen, that one class you need to create for a window, adapter demo class you need to create for a window, then rest of the classes you have to create for listening these events from this window. So you can avoid this by having inner classes. So first we'll see one program. See, applet AWT event, where a class mouse pressed demo extends applet, same thing, it just adds mouse listener interface. And who will be the listener here? My mouse adapter, which is extending mouse adapter class. This is an adapter class provided by Java, and this is a class created by user. Okay, adapter. Then you are having object of variable of this class here, right? Then you are having a constructor. Then you are taking the address here, this your address of this window here, and you are storing it. Then you are using show status method to show mouse pressed. This can be avoided using inner classes. The same code we can write using inner classes. Just see, this was the main applet window, right? See, here we will have a class called inner class demo that extends applet. So this is our window, and window's name is inner class demo. So this will be the source. Now in that, what you're doing, you are having again init add mouse listener new my mouse adapter. You are not passing any this here, and see, this applet was opened here and it was not close anywhere. This is a close for in it. So within that class, you have declared another class called my mouse adapter. So this becomes an inner class for this inner class demo class. Now, what it is going to do, it is extending mouse adapter. Same, no need to have any constructor, just directly write mouse pressed and use just show status. If your class is, if your this class is applet is different from this class, or this class my mouse adapter is outside this mouse press demo, then you need to have this kind of burden. If this is declared inside this mouse press demo, which is applet, then no need to have any constructor, no need to store the address, then through address you no need to call show status. Just what you need to do is you need to create an inner class which extends a mouse adapter, and inner class can access all the methods of its outer class, right? So outer class is extending applet. Applet has show status method, and show status method is directly available for my mouse adapter, and it will show you mouse pressed. Okay, now proceeding further, we have anonymous inner class. What is anonymous inner class? Anonymous means what? Which doesn't have any name, right? So in this example, you have seen that we have an inner class, but for that inner class, we had a name. See, for that inner class, we had a name called MyMouseAdapter. So in this, we are going to create an inner class that doesn't have any name. That doesn't have any name. So how? See, be careful about this anonymous inner class, because to implement any listener, we are going to use in future classes, we are going to use anonymous and inner class itself. Okay, so be concentrated during explanation of anonymous inner class. Okay, an anonymous inner class is one that is not assigned a name, right? Now how? See, same thing, public class anonymous inner class demo extends applet. So you have created a window, you have created a window, and a window name is this, which is our actually source, which is going to generate a event. In this, we need some kind of listener. So first we need to write init. In init, we need to add mouse listener. See, mouse listener parenthesis opens here. Opens here. Huh. And it doesn't closes here. It closes here. Huh? It closes here. See, it closes here. It is not a wink emoji. Okay. So it closes here. Okay, now see, it opens here. Within that open and close, what we are doing, we are creating, see, new mouse adapter. What is mouse adapter? Adapter class provided by Java. See, mouse adapter, adapter class provided by Java. Adapter class provided by Java. See here, open parenthesis, then directly new adapter, then just a constructor, open floor bracket, then you are directly writing public void mouse pressed event, and takes parameter as mouse event class that I have already explained to you in previous videos. Show status mouse pressed, and this method closes here. And this, whatever the anonymous inner class, is closed over here. Now this parenthesis closed here. Okay, let me show you. Closes here. So this means here a new class is created, which is actually extending mouse adapter class. See here, explanation. Here, the syntax new mouse adapter that you have already seen here indicates to compiler that code between the braces defined an anonymous inner class. Code between this braces defines a anonymous inner class that doesn't have any name, that is extending mouse adapter. See, furthermore, that class extends a mouse adapter. See, it has a special meaning. See, if this mouse adapter is a class, if it is a class, then it is extending that class. If this is a interface, not a class, interface, then it is not extending, it is implementing. Anonymous inner class is implementing this interface. In this case, we have used class, that's why it is anonymous inner class is extending this mouse adapter class. If it was interface, anonymous inner class was implementing this interface. Okay, so have you understood what is anonymous inner class? Anonymous inner class is a class which doesn't have any address. Okay, which doesn't have any name, sorry, actually not address, which doesn't have any name. And here new keyword and entire whatever the things that you are writing, if it is a class means it is extending, if it is an interface means it is implementing. So we have already seen a program on page number 662, this program that we have already seen. Okay, I will stop here. In next video we are going to start Java Swings, a front end, okay, how to create buttons and all. Up to then, stay home, stay safe. Thank you.